Welcome to the afternoon market update from Nirmal Bang. I'm Hiral Dadia. Clearly, if you go to see the spectacular run for the markets that we've been witnessing in today's day of trade, and clearly we have been taking cues from the global markets as well. Currently, we've extended the gains for the session and for the day. And overall, if you go to see, we are at the day's highest levels as we speak. Very quickly, if you could just quickly pull up a Nifty 50 as well. It's up almost around 3.5% with gains of over 300 points coming in. We've reclaimed that 9,000 mark yet again on Nifty. Whereas Sensex is seeing gains of over 1,000 points. We're pretty much nearing that 40,000 level on the Sensex. Bank Nifty, again, smart gains coming in from the financial space as well. And it's mainly the HDFC Twins as well as RIL. These are a few of the counters which are actually aiding Nifty 50 in trade today. Broader markets also, if you go to see, the performance is pretty much in line with the benchmark indices, wherein the mid-cap index is up around 3%, whereas the small-cap index is also seeing gains in the range of around 2 to 3%. If you have to look at individual sectors right now, majority, in fact, all of the sectors are trading with smart gains in today's session. And clearly, one sector that we need to highlight today in today's session is with regards to where the Nifty Auto Pack is concerned. Smart gains coming in there. Auto index is up almost nearly around 8% as we speak. Apart from that, the other sectors which are seeing smart gains, you have the consumer-y discretionary space, which is seeing smart up move. Finance is up. Healthcare is up around 5.5%. Telecom is seeing gains to the tune of around 5.5%. Consumer durables, you know, apart from that, metals, all of them are seeing gains in the range of almost 4 to 8%. Overall, if you go to see again the advanced decline ratio as well, that's pretty much in favor of the bulls in today's day of trade. So that's something which is actually giving you some bit of strength. Especially if you see on the Sensex as well, you just have around three counters which are trading in the negative from the universe. So it's IndusInd Bank, HUL, as well as Tech Mahindra out of Sensex 30 stocks, which are trading with cuts. Let's quickly understand which are the index contributors to Sensex gains. So you have the HDFC Twins. Both of these counters are contributing almost around 330 to 340 points to today's rally on the Sensex, whereas around 100 point contribution is coming in from a Reliance Industries. ICICI Bank, Kotak Mahindra Bank, TCS are upwards to the tune of almost around 60 to 90 points each. So that's the kind of contribution that we're talking of from individual counters. Very quickly, let's just understand on Nifty 50, which are the top gainers that we've been talking about. So Cipla, Tata Motors, Hero Moto, Maruti Suzuki, Bajaj Auto, Titan. These are a few of the counters which are seeing smart gains. Whereas, we already mentioned about HUL, Tech Mahindra, IndusInd Bank and UPL. These are a few of the top losers on Nifty 50. Talking about the broader markets as well, Ashoka Buildcon, FTC, RCF, Container Corp, you have Chola Investment, LIC Housing Finance. These are a few of the top gainers in today's session, seeing gains in the range of almost around 10 to 20% as we speak. Whereas on the losing front from BSE 500 right now in intraday trade, you have Amber Enterprises, PC Jewelers, Taido Care, La Opala, Chalet Hotels, Godrej Properties, Delta Corp, seeing cuts in the range of almost 2 to 10%. Let's quickly understand if there are any stocks which are hitting 52-week highs and lows, because clearly we have the markets which are trading at the day's highest levels. Again, taking pharma cues, you have Cipla and Dr. Reddy's two counters which are trading at a 52-week high from Nifty 50, whereas the ones which are at a 52-week low, none coming in from Nifty 50. From the broader markets, you have companies like Abbott India, Ajanta Pharma, Alembic Pharma, Alkem Laboratories, Cadila Healthcare, Cipla, Divi's Laboratories, Dr. Reddy's, Torrent Pharma. It's a very interesting day. The top 10 counters on BSE 500, which are hitting a 52-week high, are coming in from the pharma space. So that's what is a buzz right now. Let's see if there are any losers coming in from the BSE 500 space. So again, it's the future group companies, future consumer lifestyle, as well as retail. All these three counters continue to be locked in lower circuit. And these are last couple of trading sessions, which have been really tough for the future group companies. Inox Leisure also under pressure. Repco Home Finance, Sadhva Engineering. These are a few of the names that have been trading under pressure from BSE 500, as well as at a 52-week low. Very quickly, let's understand which are the movers and shakers in trade, you know, and have been buzzing on the back of some news. So you have L&T Construction, which is up in trade on the back of an order win. You have Hindalco. That has been buoyed by reports that Novelis has received the final regulatory clearance with regards to where the Aleris acquisition goes. Aspen Paper and Board, the shares have spiked. Cadila on the back of the US FDA approval is up in trade. Amber Enterprises, fourth consecutive session where there's pressure coming in on that front. Granules India has also surged because they've got a US FDA with regards to a couple of drugs. You have Best Life Development. Its arm has restarted delivery services from 8 restaurants in the Delhi NCR region, and that's keeping that stock pretty much on the positive end. Colte Patil, that zoomed after its arm has entered into an agreement with Planet Smart City with regards to a development of land in a JV format. So that's what is keeping that stock pretty strong. Apart from that, overall, if you go to see Maruti Suzuki, 32% fall in production that we've seen in March, yet smart gains coming in on that counter for a second consecutive session. And if you talk about IDBI Bank, that's shining strong because the board has approved rupee bond borrowing limit to almost around 7,500 odd crores for FY21. So these are the movers and shakers of trade today. But very interestingly, if you see in terms of where markets are concerned, pretty much we've reclaimed that 9,000 mark on Nifty 50. Let's see if we are here to stay. And overall, being a Thursday, it is weekly expiry. So let's see if there is any volatility that does creep in the last hour of the trading session. And what's the impact that European markets also have on India right now. But clearly seems to be a good day of trade for the investors as well as traders. That's all that we have in the afternoon market update. Thanks for watching. In fact, you could subscribe to our YouTube channel as well as follow us on our social media handles like Instagram, Facebook, as well as Twitter.